Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I am Curtis, and I am gonna introduce a Linux Household Users course. This is just a small project. If you wanna relax and learn, you may do so. There are no assignments. Once again, this is just an open learning application, so enjoy. Thank you. Once again, welcome back to our Open Linux course. I am gonna just clear the screen and introduce some general software licensing first. Do our terminal and enter the clear command. We'll clear the screen up to the directory that we're in, but I will print out the line of what we're in, which this agreement, or if you will, set of agreements, are found in slash user share slash common licenses. Now I am already in there, so I'll less to list it out, or in my case, would rather long list it, and we're gonna use Nano and look at the GPL3. Notice I use tab completion. It will auto-complete my command, and we go forth, and it'll list what's available as we tab. Basically, this gets updated, and it is telling you how to use the software. This is free, but not as in free beer, meaning in certain places, in certain parts, it is free. But in other cases, such as racking, not free all the way around. So I wanted to give a quick pointer as to where that is. That way you may reference at it at any time. Now let me X out of there and show you some basic listing, directory, and the cat commands. So what I'm going to do is back up to the main tree directory, which I'll get into later. ls-l again. My directories are in blue, and we will cat the CPU info out of the proc folder. And I want to show you where this is. I know where it is offhand, but it's better to expound the first time. So we want to cat just the important items of our CPU info. CPU info with tab completion. Let me highlight it and show you right where that is and how I got to such. Now, it just is there to show you the first few lines of a text file, but enough to show you that this is an old machine still running. So if I would want to know the model name of my processor, this is one of the first files to check, and cat can get you there. Let me also show you another. Let me list out what BSD contains. Basically, the first few lines only. That way, you may preview what you like and then exit right away. Now, let me get a new terminal. And we will show you how we can make some new directories and list those. First of all, you've noticed I use ls. So I'll use ls space optional. That'll be a long listing. Now, if you're ever lost, you may man your command. This is going to allow you to see all its purposes and its options if you're ever in a bind. Now, in order to make a directory, we're going to use mkdir How about we go with Pluto? And now that I made Pluto, I use ls again to verify it, and now we know it's there. We're going to go in there with cd space capital P L tab, and it will complete. As you can see, there's nothing in there. Let's go ahead and make a folder with a dash in it, such as cold ice. you want to use dashes in your long folders to make sure they stay together. In this case, I have cold ice, but if I do not make then I'm gonna make both of them, but now you get two separate ones, so make it a habit to use dashes. Also, door from DOS will work, but it will not colorize your items. So please use LS. Nano is what I've used to open the GNU agreement. It will be one of many to open an edit text. VI is another. But notice it is harder to use. Now, if I'm wanting to make a text file and I want to know my definite name and just save it to save it without having to name it, then that's where touch have a cold ice ministries text file. Then if I do ls pipe less, it allows me to go up and down. I think I'll keep my lesson short and stop there for now. Thank you.